Brain health is complicated. I truly believe we are only just starting to understand how complex the brain is. One of the things that I really love about cycling is that your mind can wander, but it also requires a bit of attention too. The Phoenix geography really does inspire me a lot. It's just really a lot of fun to be able to have these landmarks on the horizon that you can navigate to. And for me, that's really important because in science, we have to be open to new ideas, new directions at any moment. We never know when that next piece of data is going to lead us down a different path.
Beautiful day in paradise.
Absolutely glorious.
Yeah.
It's remarkable changes in this area, wouldn't you agree, in the last 20 years?
I was thinking the same thing, you know, just realizing all the new buildings and all the changes that you and I have seen.
When I was wondering about the next phase of my career, my uncle sent me some clippings about this new institute that was emerging. And when I reached out to Dr. Trent, he really made promises that the work that we were gonna do today in the laboratories was gonna make a difference tomorrow in human health.
I grew up in Phoenix, quite a different town, about 500,000 people, and now it's the fifth largest city in the United States. So it's changed considerably. The city of Phoenix, the academic institutions, Arizona State and University of Arizona, all played in developing and taking a chance on building out genomic medicine as a major benefit for individuals.
We're now doing, in less than 48 hours, returning information back to physicians to determine their optimal way to treat a patient with a given type of cancer. Is there similar excitement in the brain?
Yeah, there's a lot of excitement in the brain. I think that we still have a lot to learn about how the healthy brain works. How do we take those principles that you've already applied successfully to managing cancer and take that and apply those to the brain?
10 years ago, Dr. Huntelman began the study of the brain using internet-based tools in a way that had not been a mainstay.
One of the first studies I did at TGen was a study of around 1,000 adults. We tested their memory and we looked at their genetics to try to identify genetic factors that were associated with their memory performance. At the time, it was quite a large study. However, we knew that it needed to expand to become much more inclusive of all members of society. And that really gave birth to the idea of MindCrowd.
Hi.
Hi, we're here for the testing.
Great, welcome.
MindCrowd is our internet-based study of the brain. It's about a 10-minute experience. We ask you a few questions about yourself and about your brain, and then you complete two different cognitive tests, and you get to see your results from those tests as well. The MindCrowd mobile lab adds a very powerful aspect to MindCrowd, and that is the ability to travel into the Phoenix community and see our participants face-to-face. Being able to interact with them, we can collect additional data that we can't collect electronically.
We not only learn about how their memory performs, we also collect blood samples, and we also check how their smell works, which we know changes with age.
This one makes me hungry.
Inside the mobile laboratory, we have a specialized MRI machine which lets us take pictures of your brain. Being able to look at the size and the shape of the various brain regions can tell us a little bit about how your brain might change with age.
I haven't seen many brains, but it looks pretty normal.
Our overall goal with MindCrowd is to reach 1 million participants, and we're almost there. Reaching that many people is really important because it helps us have the ability to study various types of people in the community.
This type of citizen science approach that he brought forward here in the city of Phoenix and is now testing across hundreds of countries has really brought data that can be uniquely used to understand aging and how we might better inform approaches that can help us think more clearly for more years.
One of the surprises that we see in the mind crowd data is really just how much variation there is in brain performance. Going into this, we expected the 20-year-olds, for example, to be much better than the 70-year-olds. However, we see quite the opposite.
All right, cheers.
Science.
I'm impressed every single day at the amount of cutting-edge research that's happening in the city of Phoenix. The work that we're doing makes a difference. And the way that we make a difference is by helping impact the lives of everyone in our community. I'm really excited about the future of memory research because I believe the things that we're learning today could make a difference tomorrow.